Let's head back to 1988 when a young Deborra-Lee Furness burst onto the global film scene in a role that would define her career. The actor had already conquered television, but it was her role as a strong-willed lawyer in the tense drama Shame that changed her life forever. To celebrate the landmark film Shame has just had a special screening in Melbourne, and that's where Angela Bishop caught up with the actress and her other half, a bloke by the name of Hugh Jackman.
A stranger on her own.
Do you want something?
Yeah, you want to give it to us, honey?
In a town ruled by terror.
Stop it!
Well, it is so amazing to see you here in Melbourne, ahead of the Melbourne International Film Festival premiere of Shame.
Premiere. It sounds so funny. This is if it was 29 years ago. My publicist is 29. She goes, that was May the year I was born. I'm like, thanks for sharing.
So when did you first get an inkling that this was going to be happening?
They wrote to me a few months ago and said they were restoring it. And I was like, wow, because I'd never heard of that happening before. And I think it's great that there are all these old, iconic Australian films, that they give them a new life and a new audience. And Shame, it's still my most favourite film. When does I was a young actress getting the chance to play this kick-ass, strong woman who really had something to say. And it was, I think, the first time I realised that what I do for a living was not just the pie in the face, people make them laugh. It was really important because I travelled around the world with it, and so many women would come up to me and say, thank you for telling that story.
And why were they saying that?
It's about rape in an outback town, and the local police and the local culture is, let's, oh, it's all like blokes being blokes, and let's sweep it under the carpet.
Just because a few lads act like nature intended.
Let's face it, this is still relevant today. I mean, a few years ago, the case in India, the gang rape, and they made a film about it, brought attention to it. In America, I know I have a girlfriend, Mariska Hargitay, the actress, has an organisation...
Law and Order SVU.
..from Law and Order called Joyful Heart, whereby she is pushing to have rape kits opened up that have been sitting on the shelves for 20 years to have accountability. I mean, I could go on and on. So it's still relevant today.
That bloody animal. Your son goes roaming the streets at night molesting women. Well, you've been fighting for it all.
Where everyone's raving now about Wonder Woman, rightly so, and these strong female characters, but you were
Atomic
doing it.
Atomic Blonde with Shelley's.
Atomic Blonde. Them, you were it, doing it.
In yeah, a... way back. But there's also, I think, more comic, the comic book genre. This was really based in a sort of Australian sensibility, down to earth sensibility.
Tell me or I'll break your neck.
Yeah. You and whose army? Now get out of my way, you mad dyke.
Jesus.
So you ride into town, the opening scene, it's not a spoiler alert, but you ride into town, head to toe black leather on a Suzuki Katana, have I got the bike
katana,
right?
A Katana, oh yeah, I've got to remember it was Katana 350 or something, yeah.
You obviously learned to ride a bike, or did you already
know? No, I did. I practiced for months. I was really crap at it. So we had, I think, 7 body doubles. There is one scene where I do a wheelie down the main drag. It's my favourite scene in the film. I won't be telling the children that wasn't really mummy. but yeah, I did learn, and I had more bruises and cuts in the making of that film than any other film I've ever done.
You wouldn't want to stay in a rough joint like this. I mean, it's no place for a
lady.
The title of the movie, Shame, pertains to how the victim is made to feel, that somehow she is responsible for this and that she's labelled a slut in the town and so on and so forth.
That word just so bothers me.
Me too, but it's... Has that changed so much?
No. I mean,
does victim
you see,
blaming still
well,
go
what's
on?
Happening? These women have acid poured on them. Their family bears the shame after they've been raped. But to me, the shame is such a powerful emotion. Don't tell me those guys don't have shame. It's in there, they may bury it. It's shame for everyone.
Isn't there some way we can resolve this amongst ourselves? If Lizzie really feels she was wronged.
She was wronged, Mrs. Rudolph.
Oh dear. I'm so sorry, Lizzie, darling. But revenge is...
What?
Well, these things happen.
Has your daughter seen it?
No.
So what's that going to mean for you, for her to see?
I love that she gets to sit, watch Mum kick some ass. To see a strong female, you know, she was a great role model for a lot of young girls.
When did you last see it?
30 years ago.
You're kidding?
No.
So you don't sit at home Saturday nights, you and Hugh, and go, let's put on some of my old films.
Yes, let's sit back and watch all the old movies. No, strangely enough, no.
Has Hugh seen it?
No, he's actually never seen it on the big screen. So he's seen it obviously on DVD, but no, he's really excited to see it.
And he's going to walk the red carpet with you, but, you know, bit background for him tonight.
He's the corporate husband today. I do enough corporate wife.
Hugh, tonight's all about Deb.
As is every night.
Well said.
As it should be, but I'm so excited. I've never seen it on the big screen. The kids have never seen the film. I think they're going to, particularly our young daughter, who's 12, is going to look, my mum is the coolest mum ever. So it's good.
Something we've all known for a very long time.
You she didn't it. Get the memo.
I think it's so relevant because it's one of the strongest female roles ever created in Australia. And I remember standing with Deb at Times Square in 1980-something and seeing her up on this poster and thinking, they finally got it right. This girl was always destined for stardom.
It was just so tailor-made for Deborra-Lee for some reason. And she just sort of walked through it like she was slipping into an old pair of shoes somehow. But with all the excitement of a new pair of shoes, if you know what I mean.
And is it nice to be home for a quick visit?
It's always nice to be home. It's always too quick, but I love it. We've been in Sydney here, we went to Broome, spent some beautiful time in WA. We've had a great, great time. Thanks.
Well, enjoy today. As I said, National Deb Day.
National Deb Day.
The media and red carpets are fabulous. I'll speak on behalf of us. We're very good people. But you guys can't walk down the street to pick up a cup of coffee without getting
selfies,
photographed.
Selfies.
Yeah. How do you find all that?
Look, you know, it's sometimes challenging, especially when we're with the kids. The kids get a little, you know, like, oh, selfie time. It goes with the territory, you know. It's challenging. We get a lot of perks. We always get a reservation at restaurants. So, you know, it's one hand, pays off.
Nothing to complain about?
No.
Nothing.
Why, it's a waste of time. Why complain? Movingon.com.
Movingon.com. You two have something very close to your heart that it's also happening in Melbourne in the not too distant future, which is the Red Ball. That's another one clocking up a bit of an anniversary, isn't it?
25th Silver Jubilee, and my mother, who passed away last year, was...
Beautiful Faye.
Beautiful Faye, and this is her baby. She co-founded this organisation. It was her baby for 25 years, and the Red Ball Night was always the biggest night, so this year is very special. Fight Cancer Foundation does amazing work with research, with supporting families that... A lot of families live in the country towns, and their kids have to come in town for treatment. They have accommodation where they can stay close by. We have back-on-track programs to keep kids who've been out of school, to keep them on their educational path. They've been doing amazing work for 25 years.
Your work with adoption here in Australia continues. Since we last spoke, there have been some developments in some areas.
I am thrilled that locally now there is a cut-off limit and that children that have been permanently removed from their families are now able to have permanency. People don't understand how the word permanent is a big deal, so they can be adopted. I love Rachel Griffiths was speaking out recently about orphan tourism. So people have well intentions of going in to visit children in orphanages, realising that you're actually perpetuating a system that is not serving children. I would love to direct a film. I think that to me would be a great canvas, and I'm very visual, so I'm sort of sussing out at the moment and trying to find a like-minded screenwriting partner so we can create something.
I have a feeling that might be a strong female sort of story.
There perhaps probably will be, but they'll, yeah, but a mix, and I love relationship. I love how we dance as humans.
Would you work with Hugh again?
Yeah, what if there's a role for him?
He'd have to audition.
He would have to audition.
You'd have to,
really,
you know,
put him
through his paces.
He might have to sleep with the director.
Does that go on?
Apparently.
The casting couch is real.
Apparently.
So good to catch up with you. And, you know, congratulations. I think this is a really special moment and I think you should treasure it.
Thanks, Angela. So now you're